Combining a blend of Middle Eastern heritage and contemporary Dubai, the award-winning Palace Hotel is fit for a king, and the five-star establishment welcomed the tennis equivalent of royalty before the men's Dubai Duty Free Championship got underway. A feature of the luxurious hotel is its central location and breathtaking vantage points of the Burj Khalifa and Dubai Fountain, and Roger Federer had the best seat in the house. After missing the previous 2 years due to injury and illness, the four-time winner here is fit, healthy, and thrilled to be back.
I've had really good years here in Dubai, and I've also had tougher years because of injuries and sickness like last year, and I'm excited to be playing again. You know, obviously the tournament hasn't started yet, so I still have to make a few days, but I feel really good in practice and had a good time off after the Australian Open, and here we are where I spent actually quite a lot of time, and I'm excited about the tournament.
In a five-year stretch from 2003 to 2007, Federer has had plenty of time to soak up the atmosphere at the Aviation Club, with his only blemish coming in 2006, when losing in the final to regular sparring partner Rafael Nadal.
I think the tournament runs a great tournament, you know, for us, the players. They make us feel very special, very welcome, and obviously I have close relationship with them because I've won so many times, I've played for so many years, I really know my way around. I'm actually also a member of the club by now, an honorary member, I think I am, so it's if ever I wanted to go practice there, doors are all open, and it's obviously nice to know.
Federer is by no means a tourist here in Dubai, with the city becoming somewhat of a home away from home for the Swiss maestro and his growing family.
Well, I came here the first time years ago, obviously for the tournament, and then I came here for vacation, and I started to enjoy, you know, the place, culture, the people here. It's really an interesting place to be in a, you know, interesting area where we can sort of, you know, reach the world with one flight almost, and it's really hot here in the summer, which I kind of felt I needed as well, you know, to get used to really heat, you know, a lot of heat as well throughout the year, and on the tour when it gets really hot that I wouldn't have a problem, and it's really paid off for me. And then obviously my family enjoys it as well. It's very, very much a safe place, and that's a big appeal for us to be here.
The 16-time Grand Slam winner has had a great start to 2011, opening with victory in Doha and being a semi-finalist in Australia. In Dubai, he now gets the chance for redemption against his conqueror in Melbourne, Novak Djokovic.
It's been a good start to the year, really. I played great in Qatar. I think I also played really well in Australia. Obviously had a tough match against Novak, but I think he was really the best player of the tournament and deserved to win. So it's still a long year ahead of us, so it's only the beginning, but I'm happy it started well for me, and I'm very confident for what's to come.
While pundits continue to predict decline and opponents look for weaknesses, Federer shows no signs of either. The 29-year-old is confident of many more years on top.
I still want to enjoy my last years on tour, and I still feel like I have many left, so that's why I'm not planning, you know, any retirement anytime soon. And obviously I'd like to spend time with the kids and, grew up in Switzerland and all that stuff. But at the moment the full focus is on the tour and, you know, being the best possible dad and husband I can be, and kind of go from there. You know, it's already a challenge enough to do all those things together, and I'm excited about where my life is right now, and hopefully I can play many, many more years to come.